Alright guys, welcome back to another episode of Assassin's Creed 3. We just got out of that room back there where we killed a guy. So I guess we gotta kind of exit this staircase very carefully. I don't know how careful we gotta be, but we gotta exit this area. What happened?
Calm, please!
Oh no! Oh! That guy just got wrecked! Whoa. What happened?
I beg your pardon.
Peace, friend. There is no danger.
No pushing, please.
Patience, please.
Let us out. The man was holed up there.
We must have order.
All right, I'm walking as fast as I can here. People are going to find me.
You've just been left here to rot.
It happened right in that balcony.
What are those men doing in there?
Yeah, what are they doing in there? I know, I gotta brush up on my English accent.
Hey,
listen, you don't call me an imbecile. I don't know.
Where are you going?
Why are they just randomly pulling people aside here? They don't even look like there's anything wrong with them. Unless they're all like sketchy looking, maybe. Listen, buddy, look out. Alright, we made it out. We must get in here and hope that that is a safe guy. He looks kind of sketchy, too.
And how was the opera?
Rather dull, truth be told.
Shall we be off then?
Aye. To Fleet and Bride.
By your command.
Thank ya. Wonder what significance this has. Hello, Mexican Tacos 420.
Gentlemen, I hold in my hand a key. And if this book is to be believed, it will open the doors of a storehouse built by those who came before.
I see.
Ah, yes.
Ooh.
Those who ruled, reigned, and vanished from the world.
Yep.
Do we know what it is that will be held within?
Nope.
It could contain certain knowledge. Perhaps a weapon or something as yet unknown. Unfathomable in its construction and purpose. It could be any of these things, or none of them. They are still an enigma, these precursors. But of one thing I am certain. Whatever waits behind those doors shall prove a great boon to us all.
I don't even know what boon means. If anybody knows, let me know.
They won't. You've seen to that.
I assume you know where this storehouse is.
Ah, Mr. Harrison.
Gentlemen.
Like, did he not see?
How fair your calculations?
Did he not see him there before?
I believe the site lies somewhere within this region.
Somewhere within there?
My apologies. Were that I could be more accurate. That's all right. It suffices for a start. And that is why we've called you here, Master Kenway.
Yes.
We'd like for you to travel to America, locate the storehouse, and take possession of its contents.
I'm yours to command. Although a job of this magnitude will require more than just myself.
Of course.
Yep. I need some people to work with.
Upon this paper are the names of five men sympathetic to our cause. Each is also uniquely suited to aid you in your endeavor. With them at your side, you will want for nothing.
Well, then I'd best be on my way.
I knew our faith in you was not misplaced. We've booked you passage to Boston. Your ship leaves at dawn.
Sweet, I'm going to Boston. Ah, yeah.
Go forth, Haytham. And bring honor to us all.
I will, sir. A deadly performance. Mission complete. 100 of 100. Full synchronization. Winning. Look at me. I look like such a boss. Oh, that is so cool. Look at the shards everywhere. Sounds like we're at some dockyards. Or on a ship. Atlantic Ocean on day 2. Okay. That looks awesome. Look at that. That is so cool. I really like old ships, like that, like big old ships. Pretty cool.
Some fresh air might do me good.
Oh, upper deck's this way. Hello, deckhand. What, we can't go up here? Let me up. Wait, what'd that say back there? New York? Oh, it's like a shipping boat or something. They got all the stuff that needs to be going to that spot. Or no, it's just a luggage for different people. Okay. Makes sense. Up to the top we go. Scrub that deck. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Interact.
Captain?
Mr. Kenway.
I just wanted to thank you again for taking me aboard. And apologize for any inconvenience it may have caused.
Inconvenience would be an understatement.
I'm sorry, I don't follow.
My ship was held in port for 2 days that we might accommodate you. I lost several contracts as a result.
I had no idea.
Of course not. You nobles are all the same.
Well, that was rude. We are very nice people, thank you very much. Come at me.
And then all will be well.
Brethren.
Are you sure about that?
Of course. Have I ever led you astray?
Nah. No, you don't sit right with the others.
Have faith, my friend. You'll see.
Well, well. Seems our esteemed guest has deigned to grace us with his presence. You might want to head back to your quarters. Top deck's no place for tender Parnells.
So I thought. And yet here you are.
Fancy yourself a joker, eh? Let's see how funny you find this.
All right, let's fight. Yeah, let's do this.
Stay out of this.
Yeah.
Finish the hoity-toity.
Oh, yeah. Oh, counter for days.
Look at how he bumbles about. Pathetic.
Oh yeah, another counter. Never will you touch me.
Give him a douse on the jump.
How do I fight this guy? Can't I just fight him? Do I actually just have to... Like, I'm just countering this. This is no fun. All right, here, and then A.
Anoint him with the oil of gladness already. I want my money.
I don't understand what I'm supposed to be doing here. Yeah. Nobody can even understand you. Fight me, guys.
To hell with the captain. And to hell with you, Mills. Who side you on anyway?
Ah, yeah? Ah, yeah. You can't take me. Now pretty boy here is going to take me.
What is that? You think I'm afraid of you?
No. But you should be.
Oh yeah, you should. Yep, sit down.
Do you yield?
Never!
Uh-oh. Yeah? Oh, he's got his knife out now. B, then A. Ha ha! Taken.
What's the
Now what?
Captain! Explain yourself at once, Mr. Kenway!
Listen.
He's thought we were simply passing the time with a bit of sport, Captain.
How about you pass the time by doing your goddamn jobs instead? I wasn't aware I was paying you to loll about.
Sorry. Didn't mean to.
Please, Mr. Kenway.
Listen. You don't need to worry about me, just worry about your crew. Aha.
There's your knife back.
Didn't even... I got hit one time.
I don't care for you, Mr. Kenway. I've had nothing but trouble since you came aboard.
Your problems have nothing to do with me.
I beg your pardon?
You're a poor leader, ill-tempered and cruel, and it's clear your crew has no respect for
you. That's right. I tell it how it is.
I don't want to argue. In fact, I need a favor.
Oh, this is rich.
I suspect some of the men intend to mutiny.
Really? What a surprise.
As I cannot trust any of them, I am compelled to turn to you.
And why should I help you?
Because if they do intend to betray, I'm the only hope you have of reaching America alive.
Okay.
Well, what will it be?
If what you say is true, what
hey, Jacob, how are you? Thank you for being in the middle of my video.
But let me be clear. Should you ever dare to insult or threaten me again, I'll not hesitate but to cut off your head myself. Are we understood?
Oh, yeah? Yeah, now you're scared. Way to shut him up right there. That was funny.
Good day.
I like this game. I'm gonna have fun. Can I like just push this guy off? Oh no, that sucks. Oh well. I guess we gotta go back to the quarters here, the sleeping quarters, and see what happens from there. Interact. Oh, we're gonna stare at this some more. I really wish I knew what that was. If any of you guys know what it is, please just comment in the down below there. Let me know what it is. I don't know, but I'm writing one big journal there. And you know what? I love how there's already words written and I just wrote over them. Well, now we're sailing at night. Day 28? I've been on the ship for 28 days? Actually, that makes sense. Never mind. We must almost be there. Hello, Bran.
Mr. Kenway.
Captain?
Whatever they're up to, I believe it's coming to a head.
I'd best get to work.
Okay, let's go see what's up with these guys, because I can take them all. I sure can take them all.
He's cut our rations again. Claims we're not proofed.
Actually, let's go talk to this guy.
You looking for another fight? That it? Go away.
Attitude. Pretty much what I expected from him. Oh no, I didn't want to play. No. Back. Not what I wanted to do.
Quite the basting you gave Graves and Quill.
Yes, I did.
Wasn't by choice. Aye. Blockheads, the both of them.
Yeah.
Where are my manners?
You're pretty.
Louis Mills. Pleased to meet you.
Atham Kenway.
You're a cool guy.
So, should I be watching my back?
I think the boys learned their lesson. They're normally not so nasty. Honest, it's just the past few crossings have been a bit rough.
Oh?
Captain's trying to cut costs, reduce rations, lower wages, more dangerous cargo. It's put the crew
sounds
on
like
edge.
It sucks.
Is there cause for concern, then?
Not if I can help it. But the captain needs to think about the way he treats his
men. Yes, he does. He's not a very nice guy. Alright, well, let's get on to what we're doing here. I'm not gonna even bother going down there. What? What? We missed something here. Uh-oh, geez, we're not supposed to do that. Fast walking, not running. I completely missed this guy here.
You there, I have some questions for you.
That's nice, but I ain't got time to gossip. Probably wouldn't have anything useful to share anyway. You want information? Try the cook or the doctor. Everyone's always chatting them up.
No, I want to talk to you. Or not, I guess. Let's talk to this doctor guy over here. I don't know who this is, but we're going to go talk to him. You look like the cook.
Won't be serving for another couple hours. Some biscuits in the barrel if you're desperate.
Actually, I've come with a question.
What's that?
Yeah.
Have any of the men been acting strange recently? Said anything that struck you as out of the ordinary?
The boys cry about the rations, as if there's anything I can do about it. But beyond that, I ain't heard much. My advice? Go find James. His ears are always open.
All right.
And where might I find him?
Right behind you, actually. He's the one sitting on the barrel.
Okay. I'll go talk to James then. You're not on a barrel. It wasn't really right behind me.
Are you James?
Aye.
Haytham Kenway.
Hello.
Pleased to meet you.
I know who you are.
I was hoping you could answer some questions.
I figured as much, but not here. Follow me.
All right.
So, what do you want to know?
Have you seen or heard anything out of the ordinary since we left port? Anything that gives cause for concern?
Some of the men have been gathering at night on the upper deck. I've only caught bits of their conversations, so I couldn't say for certain what they're up to. But I suspect it bodes ill.
Is it a mutiny they're planning?
All I know.
Listen,
is
boy. Look at me when you're talking.
Mills has been trying to talk him down, but there's only so much one man can do.
That is true.
Thank you for the information.
Thank you very much, James.
I only wish to see us reach the colonies alive.
Yeah, that's true. I need to get to Boston, what I need to do. Let's run up here real quick. Aha! I found you, whoever you are.
Evening, sir.
How are things?
Calm and quiet. Just the way I like it. What brings you topside?
Thought I'd wander a bit. Stretch my legs. That's all.
Take care where you tread. The deck hides all manner of danger in the dark.
What was that?
Yeah, what is that?
Someone's throwing cargo overboard. But why?
I don't know why. All right. Let's see. Let's go down there and check it out.
He's got our rations again. Claims we're not provisioned for such.
Left stick. Aha. Search this thing. Okay. It's dusty. I guess he was throwing them out of there.
Curious.
Yes.
Most curious.
Alright guys, thank you for watching this episode. We're going to continue our search for whatever we're looking for here in the next episode. So I will see you guys next time.